I don't really know how to answer that. I'm happy, yeah, but really no different than previous weeks.
What was the difference on the punt team in your eyes? Was it the blocking, the return man, or a combination of both?
I think it was a combination of both. I mean, the defense did a great job, you know, field position-wise, you know, holding them down there. There were some long yardage situations. You know, we blocked well on the outside and on the inside, and then Tyler did a great job fielding the ball and hitting it downhill, which is what he does. So I think it was a combination of all those things.
After seeing him now in action, or just film, what exactly do you like about him as a return man?
I mean, he's aggressive, and I mean, he's the definition of a north-south returner. You know, when we scout people and stuff, we talk about this guy's a perimeter guy, or he likes to get the ball out to the field and those kind of things. But he truly wants to hit it north and south, and isn't afraid. I mean, he runs behind his pads. You can tell he's a running back and stuff, and you know, runs behind his pads and has good vision, and it just hits the return downhill and run through contact, which you always appreciate. And he's getting the maximum amount of yardage that's there.
Yeah, I was talking to him last week about how important it is to field the ball, like, in, I guess, with momentum, mm-hmm. in the right place. Does he do that maybe better than some guys?
No, he does a good job judging it and stuff. I mean, you always want him to beat the ball to the spot and catch it squarely, and then he's got a good feel for who's around him and, you know, where he can go with it and stuff. So, yeah, he's got good vision.
I don't want to make more of it than what it is, but is there – I mean, we've asked you about this every week for a month and a half. I mean, is there a bit of a weight that is lifted when you finally see all that hard work pay off into something positive?
Sure. I think anytime you work hard at something, you always want to see the fruits of your labor. And I know our guys are, you know, we've worked hard in practice, and our guys are really bought in and have done a good job with that. And I, like I said before, I've seen us improve, and it wasn't showing up on game day, especially in that area, but I just see us fundamentally improving. And just when you can talk to guys on the sidelines and you don't have to show them something or have a whiteboard to draw it up, because you can talk to them because they understand what you're talking about and the, you know, adjustments and things like that, you know, the guys are coming along. And so it's always good that, you know, you have positive results and see good things happen.
Just guys, big picture. You feel like you've turned a corner. Obviously, JK's punting the ball pretty well last couple games. You know, the return game was good last week. Your kickoff coverage has been good for like 5 or 6 games now.
I, like I said, I feel like we're improving in all areas. I mean, you just want to continue to see the growth and those things. And, I mean, it's a week by week. To me, it's 16 one-game seasons. You know, you can build confidence based on improvement, but at the end of the day, you still have to go out and do it on Sunday. And, you know, we talk about one play at a time. I mean, we don't get a second or third down like, you know, offense or defense does. If you screw it up, it can lead to a big kickoff return or a big, you know, punt return, or, you know, vice versa. You can lose yardage on things and stuff. But our guys have done a really good job of focusing on the details and continuing to try to improve with the little things. And I see that happening. And so, you know, to say we've turned the corner, no. I mean, you know, if you have a bad game, then, you know, you can say you haven't. But I feel like we're continuing to improve, and I like where we're going.
Is this about the best returner duel you're going to see, or you have seen, I should say, between Cohen and Patterson?
Yeah, I think so. I mean, obviously their resumes speak for themselves. I mean, you know, two Pro Bowl returners that, you know, I know Cordarrelle's one of the best of all time as far as his average and having 7 career touchdowns. And, you know, he's just a big guy that hits it. And, you know, Cohen's been a Pro Bowl returner and is dangerous every time he touches the ball. So, yeah, I definitely – and Chris does a great job with, you know, getting those guys blocked up and getting them free and stuff. So it's definitely the best dual returners we've seen.
Sean, do you wait till game day to decide whether you can ask Mason to kick away and try to get it out of the end zone? Do you have to see what the conditions are like, or do you have an idea going in?
We always have a plan as far as what we're going to try to do, you know, as far as, you know, we want to kick a certain direction, or, you know, we're going to try to hit it out and those kind of things, and then we'll adjust that. You know, we practice kickoff today in our kickoff fits, and he understands the plan we're going to try to do and those kind of things. But you always have to adjust once you get out there and, the, you know, the, see what the wind conditions are and what the field conditions are and those kind of things. We may want to tee a ball up in a certain spot and the ground's chewed up, so you've got to move the ball off a certain area and stuff. So you always adjust on the fly, and, you know, having a veteran like him that's able to, you know, he can adjust and do those things and stuff is always really helpful.
I think last year's in December, they tried a fake punt. Obviously, they're in a situation where every game is a playoff game now. I mean, is there – I know there's always emphasis, I'm sure, on being prepared for such things, but I would imagine knowing Chris, knowing his history a little bit,
sure.
Is that an added emphasis considering what they might like to do?
Yeah, I mean, I know Chris is aggressive and stuff, and, you know, we'd run fakes in the past. So, you know, we've looked at all those fakes with our punt return team and our defense stay and all those things. We've watched all those and, you know, and talked about that and stuff. So our guys are well aware of what's at stake and, you know, those kind of situations and stuff. So we'll continue to prep them on that and just make them aware of everything that they've done and, you know, those kind of things.
Do you have a book that you and he came up with of fakes, you know, just fake plays that you can go back to years ago?
I mean,
yeah, it's, you know, we've got the playbooks from the past and those kind of things and stuff. I mean, we know each other well and stuff. I mean, we know, you guys know our history and stuff. So it's, you know, I'm sure he's come up with some more things and stuff. He's a great coach and does a great job and stuff. But, you know, so far I know what we've done in the past and things and how it's blocked up. So
I know we asked you about Mason, JK, and your returners. Has there been a guy, whether it be a coverage team or something else, that has stood out to you as doing a really good job this year?
I hate to single anybody out. I mean, we're a young unit, and again, that's when you coach the bottom third of the roster, you're working with a lot of young guys. But I think all of our guys, just watching them from day one to where we are now, have all made significant jumps as far as fundamentally and things. I'd hate to single one guy out, but you know, we're getting a bunch of guys that are leaders now and are vocal leaders and those things. And even our practice squad guys. I mean, we did some things today that, you know, that. I see the growth in those guys, too. I mean, we're working with those guys before and after practice and just trying to, you know, get those guys developed and stuff because you never know when their time's coming. So, you know, I think all those guys have made significant improvements.
You're a mean one, Mr. Grinch. You really are a heel. You're as cuddly as a cactus, you're as charming as an eel, Mr. Grinch. You're a bad banana with a greasy black peel.